Good morning, CCHS. My name is Lauren Waters, and welcome back to another episode of Keeping Up with Clay-Chalkville. This month, we are focusing on springtime and new life as we enter the last semester of the school year. First, I'm going to hand it over to Terry Jones with some motivation to help us get through the last 2 months of school. Check it out.
Hi, Terry here. As we all know, spring is approaching. And springtime is all about growth. So let's grow our mindset. Don't say I'm going to fail. Instead say, I'm going to succeed. You would be surprised how much you can accomplish when you speak positively. You can be anything you want when you speak it. Don't say, I'm about to give up. No. Instead say, I'm going to finish strong. Attitude is everything. We can be anything when we put our minds to it. Grow your creativity. Being creative is always a great way to find out about yourself. Draw, even if you don't know how. You can make scribbles. Dance, even if you can't. It's good for the soul. Sing, even if you sound like a dying bird, as long as it brings you joy. Now take these positive thoughts with you into spring break. You're welcome.
Thanks, Terry. This week, Jillian Johnson got a chance to sit down with our counselors to get some tips on how to finish out the school year.
Hey Clay-Chalkville, this is Jillian Johnson, and today I sat down with one of our counselors, Mrs. Snowden, and I got her to give us some tips on how to finish the school year out strong. Let's see what her tips are.
Hey CCHS! So I have been asked to give some tips of how to finish out this school year. We only have a few weeks left. We're about to have spring break and then start the fourth 9 weeks, so we are almost done. So hang in there, guys. So a couple of tips. Stay focused. We only have a few more weeks. If any of you are traveling down South Hall, I'm going to shout out Miss Culpepper. She has been putting up the number of school days left every day, so that countdown is on. But stay focused. Remember, your grades do matter, and your final grades affect your GPA. If you need to look at your grades, you can always check your iNow. If you don't know your iNow information, you can stop by the main office. Miss Garrett can get you that sign-on information, or you can email one of your counselors. We'll be happy to give you that so that you can stay up to date and know what your grades are. My next tip is to breathe. Take time for yourself and allow yourself to have a break mentally and physically. It's important to take those breaks and rest. Number four tip, study outdoors. So the weather is warming up, we're getting some nice, pretty sunny days. Get outside, get some fresh air, a change of scenery can always help. And then last, make it fun. Make studying fun, make school fun. Get together with your friends, but of course, make sure that you socially distance. But make it a fun thing to do. Those are my tips. Have a great rest of the school year, CCHS.
Remember, if you have any questions regarding your classes, don't hesitate to reach out to one of your counselors. They're located in the counselor suite in the back of the office.
Thanks, Jillian. This Monday is the first day of spring break, and if you're balling on a budget, Michaela Dillard has got you covered. She is telling us about the free places that we can go for spring break. Check it out.
Hi, I'm Michaela Dillard. With COVID interrupting many people's spring breaks, it can be a struggle to find things to do, especially with a pandemic still occurring. I have a few free places around Birmingham if you have absolutely nothing to do. First up is the Birmingham Museum of Arts. If you are interested in viewing a huge variety of paintings, this is the place for you. The art varies from Asian, European, American, African, pre-Columbian, and Native American cultures. It's absolutely free and it's open from Tuesday to Saturday, 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., and Sunday, 12 to 5 p.m. Make sure you don't come on a Sunday because it will be closed. After that, you can easily go a few streets down to the Birmingham Civil Rights Museum. If you missed out on Black History Month last month, you can easily catch up by visiting this museum and learning some facts about what happened during the Civil Rights Movement. It's open Thursday to Saturday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. Try to show up no later than 2 p.m., as that is the last time for last round admissions. I made that mistake. Please don't make the same mistake as me. Finally, you can visit the Botanical Gardens a little past downtown in my book. Birmingham Botanical Gardens is Alabama's largest living museum with more than 12,000 different plants in its living collections. It's the most visited free attraction in Alabama, offering free admission. The gardens are open every day of the week, and spring hours will be from 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. It's an absolutely beautiful area with many cool attractions. I highly recommend visiting here when the weather is nice. It includes a lot of walking, but I totally recommend it, and it's totally worth it. You can even see this bird. Well, I don't know if it's still there, but you can go see though. So there you have it, three places to visit during the spring break. You have no reason to post that you're bored on social media when I just gave you these three options. When all fails, at least go for a walk around the park or something with some friends. Go get active so that you can come back from spring break and tell teachers that you actually did something interesting.
Thanks, Michaela. Everyone loves a good competition. That's why Tiffany Davis and Cameron McGinnis hosted our very own dance battle. Who are the better dancers, teachers or students? We'll have to watch and find out. Tiffany?
So we are here with the teachers.
On the teacher side, we have Miss Forte, Miss Evans, and Miss Bridges.
The students?
On the student side, we have Dwight, Lene, and Dean. Let's see who's gonna win in 3, 2, 1.
The teachers lost that one. All right, it's okay though. Y'all ready for the next song? So you can see that the teachers won that one for sure. Let's see if they can win the next one.
Lean with it, walk back, 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 lean with it, walk back.
So the teachers got two. Woo! But the students have one. What? All right, this the last song. Well, I think the teachers and the students did great, and we're going to end off with Corvette.
Corvette, Corvette, hopping from jet like jet, and me dancing like that. They were like, "Pop, why you walk like that? Why you talk like that? Why you walk like that?"
Thanks, Tiffany. As you all know, last month was Black History Month, and while we often celebrate the leaders of the past, there's one leader in our very own school system who is making history. Superintendent Dr. Walter Gonsolin. Elizabeth is here with a story. Elizabeth?
Hey, Clay-Chalkville, it's Elizabeth Whitley here, and today I did a very special interview with Dr. Walter Gonsolin. Check it out.
So my name is Walter Gonsolin Jr., and I am the superintendent of schools for Jefferson County Schools. You know, that kind of evolved, me wanting to become the superintendent evolved over time throughout my career. This is my 27th year. I can't believe I'm saying it. You know, one, I just can't believe it. I still remember the first day I started teaching. But when I first started teaching sixth grade at Generate Elementary School, I fell in love with the field of education, fell in love with those 25, 30 kids. And so then you wanted to have influence at that time. I wanted to have more influence over the entire school. So I had the aspiration of becoming a principal. And then when I became the principal, guess what? Fell in love with that as well. And I said, what about being over an entire district? And so God has truly blessed me with helping me to meet my aspirations. I've had many. Mm-hmm. Just in the education field, I started off as a sixth grade teacher. I was a behavior interventionist, an assistant principal, assistant career tech director, assistant professor, and assistant superintendent. And also a superintendent for 5 years in another district near here, Fairfield City Schools. Now, all along the way, my first job was at Kentucky Fried Chicken. I was a cook and a bear at 16 years old. And then, just being the superintendent over at Jefferson County Schools means a lot to me because, it's the second largest school district in the state of Alabama. And I've always wanted to be a part of a large system. So that meets that requirement. And in particular, being the first African American, there's a specific pride associated with that. Oh, of course, just like in any other thing in life, and those barriers can be traced back to being the first person in my family to go to college, to graduate from college. Anything that's worth, going after, you have to remember, that those desires are placed in you for a reason, and they're going to be challenges.
Thanks, Elizabeth, and thank you, Dr. G. Recently, the Jefferson County Board of Education opened a new elementary school just minutes away from Clay-Chalkville High School. Simone is here with the principal of Bryant Park Elementary, Dr. Courtney Slaughter. Simone?
What's up, Clay-Chalkville? This is Simone Smith with CCNTV, and on this episode of Keeping Up with Clay-Chalkville, we took a tour of the new elementary school, Bryant Park, and got an interview with their principal, Ms. Slaughter.
Dr. Courtney Slaughter, principal, Bryant Park Elementary School. Prior to becoming a principal, I was an assistant principal at Fultondale Elementary for several years, and prior to that, I taught physical education at Concord Elementary School. It's been really nice coming to the Bryant Park community and really just the Clay community, not necessarily just Bryant Park, but the Clay community has been very welcoming to our faculty and staff with us being a brand new school. The city of Clay has been more than supportive, and it's just been nice to get to know a community. Bryant Park is a really sweet school with sweet students and parents, and it's just been a really nice, new, and fun school year. So this year we've had roughly between on average 100 to 150 students that are on remote learning. So there are some students who have been doing that all year long. So I have students that I have not been able to physically meet yet. So that kind of affects you as an administrator because you don't get to build the relationships with the students off campus. So that would be the biggest thing, is just not being able to see and interact with the remote students.
We would like to thank the Bryant Park staff for making us feel welcome, and we are excited for the future of the school. See you later, Clay-Chalkville.
Thanks, Simone. We end today with a few tours of classrooms in our very own school. There are so many unique classrooms that teachers have created so we can enjoy fun learning environments. We wanted to highlight some of them. Sam?
Hey y'all, this is our segment called Cool Classrooms, where we go around to teachers that we think have the coolest classrooms and ask them why they have their classrooms like that and do they think it helps their students. Check it out.
I decorate my room the way I do because I like a lot of color. It has that color. I think it helps with the learning process. I think kids feel more homey when they come in my room, and that's kind of what I want them to feel when they get here.
I choose to decorate my classroom in order to promote engagement, and a lot of what you see is student artwork and things about like college and career, and also just a lot of different art supplies that we use in the classroom.
So I like to make sure that my room is a happy space where I enjoy being, so I have lots of plants that make me feel like it's a place for life and to be excited. And I also want to put a ton of stuff up in Spanish to help my students if they ever forget a word or don't know. I want to make sure that they can reference like any of the materials on the walls to help them kind of frame themselves or look, get the word that they need.
I like decorating my room, and the reason that I do it is because I think it helps make the students feel more comfortable. It also immerses them further in the Spanish language because they're just not looking at it in a textbook. I want them to have realistic views of different aspects of Spanish, like the Day of the Dead is one thing that I highlight. And also I have a rich Spanish word wall. I have hola bienvenidos in big bold letters in my room. And it's just to help them practice the language. Every time they come in, they can just be reminded, hey, we're in Spanish. And they actually think it makes them feel comfortable.
We hoped you liked that, and let's move on.
Thank you guys so much for watching this month's episode of Keeping Up with Clay-Chalkville. This has been Lauren Waters with CCNTV. Have a great day, CCHS.